This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there once again, welcome to episode 26. In this episode, we're going to give you an equation in factored form, and we're going to show you how to sketch the graph of it. Let's have a look. Alright, so our equation is y equals x plus 3 squared times x minus 1 times x minus 4. Let's try to lay the general framework of this graph out first before we do anything else. The first question we have to ask ourselves is, what degree is this equation? Alright, so let's look at all the powers that are in this equation. We have a second power, we have a first power, and we have a third power added together, and you have degree 6. Now, whether the degree is even or odd will make a difference. If you have an even numbered degree, your graph will look something like this. It may have a few more twists and turns in it, though. If you have an odd degree, it'll look kind of like this. Again, it might have more twists and turns in it. The most important thing to realize is that if it's even, you'll have it coming in from the top, it'll curve around a bit, and then come back up. If the value of the coefficient in front of it is negative, then it'll just be upside down. If it's odd, it'll start at the bottom, work its way across, and then start going up really fast here at the end. Again, if the coefficient is negative, it'll just be flipped upside down. So our degree is 6, which is an even number. So knowing that, let's try to start sketching the graph here. It's going to come in from the upper left, it's going to curve around a bit somewhere in the middle, and then it's going to exit toward the upper right. So we'll go ahead and draw arrows to signify that. Second thing we need to ask ourselves, now that we know what degree it is where are the intercepts? To figure that out, we'll need to break the equation into pieces. Our first piece is x plus 3 squared. Our second piece is x minus 1 to the first power. Our third piece is x minus 4 to the third power. To figure out what the intercepts are, we're just going to set each piece equal to 0. We'll say x plus 3 equals 0, x minus 1 equals 0, and x minus 4 equals 0. So let's solve all the pieces. If we move the positive 3 to the other side, we have x equals negative 3. If we move the 1 to the other side, we'll have x equals 1. And if we move the 4 to the other side, we'll have x equals 4. Let's go ahead and mark those down now. Here's negative 3. Here's our 1. And somewhere over here, we'd have 4. We also have to pay attention to what degree they all are. That will be our third step. The degree each piece is will change how it crosses the axis. Alright, so let's have a look. Our first piece is second power. And if you have a second power on that piece, that means that the graph will touch but not cross at that coordinate. Our coordinate is negative 3, so let's try to draw that. So at negative 3, the line will come down, it'll touch negative 3, but it's going to come back up. It's not going to cross through. Let's move on to our next piece. Over here we have first power. Now, if you have first power, that means the graph is going to just cross straight through. So we're at x equals 1 now. We're just going to draw the line over there, and we're going to have it cross through at the 1. Just draw straight through the 1, and then we'll stop there for a second. Now for our third piece, we're third power. That's at x equals 4. If you have third power, you make kind of a strange shape that I'm going to call a squiggle. That's not really a technical term. It's a shape that looks kind of like this. It'll go toward 4 and then kind of flatten out and then go up really fast. Let's draw that there. We'll have it come up toward 4. flatten out and then go up really fast towards the end arrow. And now our graph is complete. It's not a perfect drawing, but it's a good enough sketch. It has all the major features. We know which way the graph is going, we know where it touches the axis, and we know how it touches the axis. Thanks very much for watching. We'll see you again next episode.